okay? Look, it's been 5 years. She's gone. You're gonna have to move on. You've got to get yourself together. I mean, look at the state of it. Look at the state of you.
Move on. Move on. Someone killed my wife in my own house.
Look, I didn't mean to annoy you.
I was on an assignment the night that she was killed. An assignment that you put me on.
Look, it's not your fault. You weren't there. You never knew it was going to happen.
She called me, screaming and yelling. So I rushed back and the door was wide open. They strangled her, Emma. Strangled.
Well, we think we found him. After all this time, there's been a string of murdered female victims, one every 3 months. This has been going on for the last 5 years. We don't know if this is the guy that killed your wife, but coming from me, this is the guy. So we'll need a warrant before we arrest him. I thought you'd want to see the face of the person who killed your wife before he ends up serving time. He's been under our noses the whole time. He's a lot closer than you ever realised. He's at number 41, Greenfield Close.
Wait. He lives there. For fuck's sake, he lives there.
Please don't do anything stupid. For Christ's sake, please, I'm begging you.
Wednesday, April 28th. I'm conflicted between good and evil, whether I should stay out of the way or avenge her. I could end my suffering right now and be with my wife. It's clear to me now what I have to do. At the cusp of noon, Jack's bridge will be dead.
If you fucking move, I'll blow your head off! So it's true. It's true, you killed my wife.
Yes.
You're fucking mental. You're insane, do you know that?
I'm not mental. You're the mental one. I'm the sane one, because I broke free from the mental hold that society has on us.
I see. So you're a psychopath then? You like to ruin lives?
Yeah, I liked it. In fact, I loved it.
What's wrong? Scared.